cannot get through the layer of the protection. And the second one is your sacrificial anode. Large bricks of metals, usually zinc, are bolted in the condenser. The ions in the water reacts with the zinc before they react with the metals of the pipes and condensers. When the zinc dissolves, the water attacks the condenser, so the brick must be replaced periodically. Then what is the step for maintaining of a cooling tower? Now in the cooling towers, generally framed with wood, is susceptible to chemical and biological attacks. Three procedures to control the deterioration of wood are chemical addition, and second is fungicidal spray, and third one is preventive maintenance. What is this chemical addition? Chemicals are added to the flooded portion of the tower. These chemicals prevent the wood from deterioration of the microorganisms build up. And second one is your fungicidal spray. The portion of the wood which is not under water, a fungicide is sprayed periodically to kill the microorganisms. And preventive maintenance, periodical inspection and replace of the rotten wood, if any. Then fouling scale and corrosion minimization in a closed cooling system, let us consider. Closed cooling system water comes from the large storage tanks of pre-treated water. It is essential that cooling water is as pure as possible. Scale corrosion, let us consider what is this scale corrosion. Scale is not as much as corrosion concerned in the cooling system as it is in the boiler. This is because the cooling temperature do not promote scale formation. However, scale can be lead to crystalline buildup in the cooler and pipes if unchecked. It is thus important to add softening chemicals to the cooling water to maintain a specified hardness in the case of hotter system, such as the water jacket of the diesel. Scale can form quickly. Then corrosion control. Corrosion both cell and chemical is a serious problem in the closed cooling water system. Oxygen pitting is not as much as problem. This is because the system is closed and not in contact with oxygen. To combat the chemical and electrochemical corrosion, chemical inhibitors are added that form of tough oxide coating over the metal surfaces. The coating prevents the breakdown of the metal. Then biological fouling control. Like oxygen, biological fouling does not present a serious problem. The water should not have microorganisms since they were removed in pre-treatment. However, to ensure a small dose of chlorine is added to ensure the organisms are killed. Then working fluid water treatment, it is very important. The working fluid water is taken from storage tanks. It is pre-treated water, but before it is added to the system, it is undergoes additional treatment. It is extremely important to maintain the steam cycle water as pure as possible. Heat and pressure speeds up and aids chemical reaction. The treatment used after pre-treatment are mechanical and chemical treatment. What is this mechanical treatment? The pre-treatment method used previously are a combination of mechanical and chemical. Once the water is introduced to the cycle, mechanical treatment are used to reduce unwanted impurities still further. Mechanical treatments includes deaeration and boiler blowdown. What is this deaeration? Dissolved gases must be removed from boiler feed water. Even tiny amount of oxygen, carbon dioxide, causes harmful. The process of removing gases from feed water is called deaeration. Two ways to remove dissolved gases are, one is mechanical deaeration and second is chemical deaeration. Mechanical deaeration removes a larger amount of dissolved gases from feed water. Chemical deaerator removes the small amount of leftover gases. Almost all modern power plants uses pressure deaerators. This type of deaerator uses steam to remove feed water gases. Pressure deaerators use steam to heat incoming feed water. Once heated, the feed water gases are more easily removed. Water is sprayed into the upper section of the deaerator to increase its surface area. Steam is also supplied to create a saturated environment. Deaerator works as dear writer works, there is a law of physics which states that the solubility of any gas in liquid is directly proportional to the partial pressure of the gas above the liquid surface. And another law states that the solubility of gas in a liquid decreases with the increase in temperature of the liquid. Non-condensable gases are removed rapidly and more completely when the liquid is vigorously boiled or scrubbed by steam. Therefore, the deaerator steam first preheats the feed water to saturation condition, then by agitation removes the air and non-condensable gases. The air and non-condensable gases are then vented to the atmosphere. The deaerator feed water along with the steam that condenses while preheating the feed water falls into the low tank. Using steam in the deaerator has four advantages. Number one is steam is available with no additional energy is required. Number two, steam heats the water which saves fuel. And number three, steam will not contaminate feed water. And number four, steam with dissolved gases can be safely vented to the air. Then what is this boiler blowdown? The working fluid in a power plant moves in a continuous cycle. Four types of water in the steam and water cycle. That is, I will explain the phase and against working fluid. In generation phase, working fluid used is boiler water. And in expansion of steam in turbine of performing work phase, steam is used as working fluid. And in condensation phase, working fluid is condensate and makeup water. And in feed phase, working fluid is feed water. The fluid is continuously being made in steam, condensed feed water into the boiler and made into steam again. However, because of leaks and vents, some water of fluid is lost in all four of the phases. This lost water must be replaced. This replaced water is called makeup. The water in the cycle must be as pure as possible. There are always impurities going into the system with the makeup. These few impurities enters the feed water system and pass into the boiler. They stay in boiler water. The water that carried them into the boiler is turned in impurities such as silica and dissolved ions is called boiler blowdown. What is chemical deaeration? Chemical treatment further reduces the dissolved gases in feed water. Oxygen is the most important dissolved gases to remove. Chemical that removes oxygen from feed water are called scavengers. Two common oxygen scavengers are sodium sulfide and hydrogen. In boiler that operates at more than 900 psi, sodium sulfide can cause problems. Although sodium sulfide costs less, large amount are needed. 7.8 ppm sodium sulfate is needed for removing 1 ppm oxygen, and this builds up a high level of undesirable solid rapidly. Using sodium sulfate is very inefficient. Feed water is wasted because the suspended solids must be removed by boiler blowdown. For higher pressure boilers, hydrogen is a more effective oxygen scavenger. Hydrogen is more expensive but removes oxygen more efficiently and create fewer problems. Hydrogen is a toxic liquid and must be handled carefully. Only 1 ppm hydrogen is needed to remove 1 ppm oxygen. Also, hydrogen adds no solids to the feed water. This prevents scale and sludge builds up inside the boiler. Hydrogen can also prevent boiler corrosion by forming a coating on water side surfaces. What is condensate polishing? This condensate polishes are demineralizers usually located between the condenser and first feed water heater. These demineralizers purify the condensate during plant operation. Condensate polishers removal feed water impurities that may have leaked into the system. What is the internal boiler treatment? This internal treatment of boiler water is very important to plant operation. Internal boiler water treatment uses chemicals to prevent boiler deposits. Following mechanical and chemical water treatment, tiny amount of impurities still remains on or may enter the boiler system through condenser tube leakages. These impurities cannot be removed completely. Thus, boiler water is chemically treated to prevent a tiny amount of impurities from adhering to tubes. Correct boiler water treatment eliminates boiler scaling and corrosion. Two internal boiler treatments are coordinated phosphate treatment and all volatilic treatment. What is this coordinated phosphate treatment? Coordinated phosphate treatment is adding phosphate compound to the boiler water. Coordinated means the treatment controls residual phosphate. Phosphate treatment prevents boiler scale and corrosion. This scale forming ions such as calcium and magnesium precipitate with the phosphate ions. The precipitation forms a suspended solids that is removed through blowdown. Coordinated phosphate treatment do not affect the feed water pH since practically all phosphates feed to the boiler remains in the boiler. Another means of controlling the pH of the boiler feed water is needed. Usually ammonia, morpholine or hydrogen is injected to the condensate system to control feed water pH. In the case of hydrogen, the hydrogen will react with scavenger and any dissolved oxygen in the feed water system, but will then be decomposed to form hydrogen reaction as an oxygen, as an oxygen scavenger. Hydrogen plus oxygen becomes nitrogen and water. Hydrogen reaction when decomposing, hydrogen becomes decomposes into nitrogen, hydrogen and ammonia. In volatilic treatment, no solid chemicals are added to the boiler or pre-boiler cycle. Typically, morpholine, ammonia or hydrogen are added to control the pH, usually between 8.5 to 9.5 of the feed water and boiler water. Thank you very much for giving opportunity for giving this presentation. Thank you. Jai Hind.